It's MGM's The Champ, a remake of the old 1931 Wallace Beery film. You probably know the story. Can a down-and-out boxer, once a champ, put his life back together again, regain his self-respect, and fulfill the faith of his young son? John Voight plays the fighter, an alcoholic, and a chronic gambler. Everybody's got at least two problems in this picture. Faye Dunaway is his ex-wife, who divorced him when he hit the skids. Now, at a racetrack barn where Voight is working as a stable boy, Dunaway tells Voight that she now wants to take custody of their son, whom she abandoned as an infant. Now, you would think that would be enough emotion for one scene. But as if all of their human problems weren't enough, the script really lays it on thick. The kid's brand new horse has just been injured in a race.
What are you doing here?
How's the horse? Is the horse all right?
The horse is just fine. 5 minutes, they'll probably shoot.
Stop it.
Stop it!
Doesn't work anymore, Billy.
What do you mean it doesn't work anymore?
It doesn't work any...
Like old times, honey. What are you doing here now? No smoking in the barn area. What do you want?
TJ's Timmy, isn't he?
Yeah, TJ is Timmy. So you figured it out, so what? Even a dumb horse knows her own foal.
Don't you think one of us ought to be with him right now? If he's out there...
One of us... One of us was for 7 years. Billy? He dropped it in the purse.
Billy, will you stop it, please?
What do you want to do? After 7 years, you want to come back. What do you want to do? Hold his hand? You know what I told him? I told him you died, that you were killed in a car wreck. That you were a tramp, that we're better off without you. You're dead, you understand that? You're dead. Kid's got no more.
I am his mother.
You're dead. He's got no mother.
I'm here. I am his mother.
You gave me custody, didn't you? And you got what you wanted. Now get the hell out of here.
Please. I'd just like to see him. I'd like to know what he's like. Is that
something? Wanna know what he's like? Take a look. He's the one in a million kid you dream about. That's what he's like. You ain't never gonna see him.
Not now, not never. Come on, let's get out.
Hold on. There's more. Voight's plummeting career sinks even lower when he's arrested for punching out his bookie's muscle men. The kid comes to visit Voight in jail, and Voight tells his son he wants him to start living with Faye Dunaway. Again, another heavy emotional scene.
How you doing, champ?
I thought you might be hungry. I brought you something to eat. Brought you some ribs.
I ain't hungry.
Okay, champ.
I don't want you to call me champ no more.
Why?
A champ don't use his fist nowhere but in the ring.
But he was trying to take a horse, champ.
I know, but don't make no difference, TJ. I had no right, see? I'm a bum.
No, you're not. Did they say when you could get out? Did they say when you could come home?
They don't know yet, TJ. Could be a month. Could be 6 months. Look, there's something we gotta talk about. You know that lady? The one at the boat, the one you're going on about how nice she is all the time.
Annie?
Yeah, that's the one, Annie. Well, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to live with her.
That kid sure blinks a lot, but that's as far as I'm going to knock his performance. That scene does drag on awfully a lot, like so many of the scenes in the movie, where the kid is reduced to walking around, crying in his sweet little voice, Oh, Champ. That's what he calls his dad, Champ. Oh, Champ. Come on, Champ. You can do it, Champ. Too much. Also, I didn't believe John Voight in this role. Most of his emotions were laid on much too thick. In fact, the whole film is really drenched in sobs and sentimentality. But my biggest objection is the same one we had a couple of months ago when Roger and I both knocked the making of a new version of Invasion of the Body Snatchers. And the objection is this. Why? Why remake The Champ? Do we really need another movie version of The Champ? You know, it isn't Hamlet. Worst of all, why waste a year out of the lives of two of our finest actors, Faye Dunaway, John Voight? Why?
I guess you could say we don't need a new version or an old version of a lot of movies, but I think people are going to movies like this now. I liked it. It's old-fashioned, it's melodramatic, it's romantic, it's a tearjerker. You can see the wheels going around, it's a machine to make you cry.
Now, wait a minute.
Okay.
You say it's a machine to make you cry. That means you're aware of something being done to you. And this is where we differ. Because as soon as I get the feeling that a movie is doing something to me, my back goes up. You liked it. Why? Why the difference?
I like the plot mechanism. I felt the old-fashioned obviousness of it was part of the appeal. A handsome guy, his poor little kid, his beautiful wife, the rich man on the ship, all the tears, the horse going, you know, everything, the big fight at the end when they're, you know, the prize fight, everything was such a cliche that I kind of relished it.
Yeah, and I just, you know, the ones that have the cliches that work for me are when I don't recognize it. Star Wars, Rocky, lots of cliches, but they're so good at it and convincing. Here, I'm watching that kid blinking. I'm seeing John Voight and I don't buy it at all.
Well, I don't go so far as to say that I think the movie is a masterpiece, but I do think I can recommend it. I think in its old, old-fashioned way, it has kind of a sunniness and a charm to it that appealed to me.
What do you think about what I mentioned before, about Voight and Dunaway in a picture like this?
I think they could certainly both be in better pictures, but on the other hand, they have been in better pictures, they will be in better pictures.
Well, that's optimistic. Now, you go ahead with the next one.
Okay.
Disagree on the remake of the tearjerker, The Champ. Roger says he likes it. I say no. I felt manipulated.